writing this movie. This is amazing.
Would you still love me if I was a worm?
This is 100% a question for my fiance. And yes, I would still love you if you were a worm, but not physically. Because that's gross. But emotionally, yes. I'd get a little worm container.
Boo!
Boo, why don't you want to fuck a worm? Boo!
I thought you loved me. Make love to a worm.
Would you still love your girlfriend if she was a worm?
No.
I would spend my life searching for the wizard that made her a worm so he could make me a worm as well. That is the only acceptable answer to say, and I hope you believe it. Love you.
What would you do to turn her back into a person?
That's a great question, sir. Because the wizard only knows how to turn people into worms. He hasn't learned the worm to people spell yet. This is not advanced wizard. If it was an advanced wizard, he wouldn't go worm. He would at least dragon.
I've become really interested in this wizard. I want to see. I see the prequel about this wizard who learns the worm spell and stops.
Well, the problem is he did the worm spell on his teacher. And then that was it. He couldn't learn anymore. That's the only spell he has.
All right, my pupil, you have learned the worm spell. Now, how to undo the worm spell is...
I'm writing this movie. This is amazing.
What's the grossest thing you've ever done?
I fucked a worm once.
And that's how he knows he doesn't like it, all right?
Gas station sushi. Oh, wow, you guys didn't... Oh, is that cuisine in Syracuse? My apologies.
Where else are you supposed to get sushi from?
Yeah.
When I was a young man, I accidentally pissed in my own face.
I'm glad I answered first.
I was in the shower, and I was right about to pee in the shower the way that children do.
And adults
as well. And I thought to myself, oh, I wonder what happens if I aim up instead of aiming down. And I looked to see what was going to happen, and then I pissed in my own face.
And that is how Isaac Newton discovered gravity.
And then when people asked him about it, he was like, an apple fell on me.
Around the time of my bar mitzvah, and I was walking around, and I really had to take a shit. I went to someone's bushes, and I just started to take a shit, and I turned around, and it was a window in someone's house, and they were just watching me.
The answer was gas station sushi. And you're like, I peed in my own face, and you're like, I shit on people.
I don't think that's that gross. You took a shit in public and people decided to watch, I'm assuming eating popcorn, just like checking you out, watching you take a shit.
You don't think it's that gross, you peed in your own face.
Yeah, Isaac Newton.
I was doing science, thank you very much.
If you could trade physical features with one other guy on stage, what would it be?
I'd take Jared's hair. Partially because, like, I know he's got a full head of hair, and partially because I know the rest of his body is broken, so... I'd take away the only thing he has that works.
You don't want my esophagus or my liver or anything like that, no?
No, I'd rather fuck a worm.
I would take Bander's heart because he's the sweetest man that I know.
It's not going to last you all that long. I would take Jared's burning foot and start doing martial arts with it. Just become a vigilante.
I think the most important thing I learned today is that neither of them want any of my physical features. I am 6'4", broad-shouldered, and you're like, fuck you. I don't want any part of this shit. I would rather put my foot on fire. And you're like, I'd rather have cardiovascular disease.
I'm not trying to make my life less comfortable on airplanes, Steve.
Thanks for watching and sharing this video. And thank you for following me on YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, and everything else. If you want to watch videos like this before anyone else, check out patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter and come to a live show. I am touring just about everywhere. You can get tickets and see where all my shows are at stevehofstetter.com. Thanks for watching.